So my name is Lian Mae. I am a rising fourth year environmental science major as well as a digital humanities minor here at UCLA, and I'm also a CDLS fellow. Got interested in my science background from taking this AP environmental science course in high school. I think I was aware of climate change like most people, but I wasn't aware to the full extent at which it was occurring. And so that class was really eye-opening because I think that was the first time that I realized I could integrate my love for science and my love for social justice into one field. In my high school, even though most of the student population were Latinx students of color, they were not really represented in their staff. So for example, most of our teachers were white, and it was just hard kind of really relating to them, and even getting empathy and sympathy from them. Definitely experienced a lot of microaggressions. A lot of them are cognizant of environmental justice issues, but then again, it's just not the same when you experience it firsthand. And so that's why it was really cool when I found out about Center for Diversity, Leadership and Sciences, because it was, again, like I said, kind of combining things I'm interested about into one program. I think like me, like a lot of people experienced imposter syndrome. So kind of that syndrome where you feel like you're kind of a fluke, like you don't really deserve to be here. And I think along with the shock from going from my high school to my college to UCLA. UCLA is just such a high caliber school with such high caliber students that it's hard sometimes when you're not doing the best in like your chemistry class, in your physics class, especially when those classes, again, don't have professors that look like you and don't necessarily know how to empathize with you all the time. How I would personally define environmental justice is bring awareness to the issues that affect the most vulnerable population when it comes to climate change, so people of color and lower income people. It was kind of surprising that there wasn't a space on environmental justice here at UCLA, that this wasn't like the core focus of any like one group on campus, considering the different issues that are happening today. So I actually found out about the Center for Diverse Leadership and Sciences when we were forming our first Climate Justice Forum. We were trying to figure out, we were basically power mapping, trying to figure out different organizations that we can reach out to on campus. And we found out about CDLS from Aradna, and she was really supportive of the entire project and the entire event. And so when I found out that they were actually starting their first fellowship the next year, I was like, I want to join. This is a really cool initiative, and I feel like there needs to be more of this out there. It's so rare to see, first of all, it's rare to see women and color, people of color in STEM, and to see her being like at the top of her field as well as having such a great initiative in CDLS, as well as just being such a great person, being such an empathetic person, I think is such a rare combination to see, and is a really inspiring combination to see, because she, like I said, is one of my biggest role models, and the fact that I can see myself in someone like her is amazing. After I graduate from UCLA, I'm planning on moving back to my hometown of Santa Maria, California, and seeing how I can help out the community there, because in order to really progress in the future, you need to look back at history, and you need to really give thanks to the community that brought you up. And so I was thinking of pursuing, so there's this nonprofit advocacy organization in my hometown, and they focus on environmental justice issues. And so I was thinking of being more involved there and just volunteering out. And then after grad school, what program? I still don't know, but that's something for me to figure out. I wish for a future where we don't need support systems like CDLS, because people of color, marginalized people, won't be marginalized anymore. I'd want to be part of that process, and seeing these great organizations exist to not exist, to finally get to that point of equity.